smaller scale, I suppose, and it's more focused on one activity, if you will. So I like that very much, and I learned a lot.
JazakAllah khair. So the anchor here is the passion. Because if you get a committee, oh, you need to work on youth. Sometimes the thing fall apart. But if remember, for example, and I'm just giving an example, a youth, to work on the youth activities, you have to be youth. I beg the difference. I've seen youth committees, older, younger, but they are passionate about it. They're passionate, they are interested. That's what I feel I love. So when in our cooperation, when we ask, there's a very common mistake when we answer, wrong answer to this question. What is your strength? How you define your strength? And we ask people, tell me, what when I ask you, what is the strength for you? Everybody answer saying, it's something that I'm good at. Wrong answer. So what is your strength, or what's the definition of a strength? It's something that I love to do, or something that I'm passionate about it. Because I have no sleep at all at night, but I have a meeting for that passion, guess what? I'll get the energy to go and do it. So one of the things that we're trying to anchor people around is my passion, what I love to do, and that will fuel this community of practices and clubs. So that's one major difference between committees and community of practices. Yes, of course, yeah, because that's a good point, actually, because some community of practices in the beginning they do ideation sessions, and there are so many ideas, and big ideas and small ideas, and they actually do that. They create an idea with a committee or a sub-team, and guess what? I had two, actually, this happened last year. One of these clubs split into three clubs, and they started as like 9 people. They ended up like 25 people with 3 different clubs. So that's, again, the rapid growth. Fadala.
JazakAllah khair. But my question was going to be, what is an average or a healthy life cycle of one of these communities?
Nah.
I mean, what's it supposed to look like in a year, 2 years, 5 years?
Nah.
Considering you want to encourage rapid growth.
Nah. JazakAllah khair. This is a great question. I usually don't talk about that, but JazakAllah khair, you give me a cue. This is a life organism. And every life organism at some point has to decay. One of the problems with committees, we think it's going forever. Nothing goes forever except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? So by design, the following slides talk about when do we shut down a club and how? Gracefully, by design. Because you don't want to lose people. Because what happened in the team is, they're not showing up anymore, nothing has been done. And everybody's like feel very negative. Sometimes I saw teams, they start as friends and they end up as enemies. I've seen that. It's just amazing. But if you design it saying, oh guys, if we're losing interest here, khalas, thank you very much, JazakAllah khair. We're shutting this down by design. And then what do? Well, we move to another club, create another club, we disperse somewhere else. We take a break, ya akhi. 3 months, alhamdulillah, by design. But we know you are in the system. You know, please go ahead. You have a follow-up. Naam, fadal.
So, based on you seeing that, what are some of the typical challenges that kind of force the lack of interest or the struggle with?
Naam, you're going really deep in the details. And I have a lot of stories about this. One challenge, I can give you actually a quick couple. One is the wrong interest was identified in the beginning. That's very, and people were like, oh, my friends are going to the da'wah or Quran club, so I'm going with them. But it's not really my passion. So after a few weeks, I'm not there anymore, and then you drop. One other thing is too technical. So you don't have the subject matter expert. So for example, that, and inshallah, I can share with you some of the information, the Justice and Law Club, we had to go, and there was a federal judge in New York, he's a Muslim brother, and he joined, so to give us, it was too technical, I didn't even know what to do, but the people were like lawyers, and they wanna attack this. So it could have failed if we didn't find that federal judge. Another one was, SubhanAllah, it missed me. SubhanAllah. The core team, this is very common because you're looking for leaders, right? And usually they have other, so many activities, they are in this masjid, in this organization, and then they are too busy to organize. Because remember, the core team has to organize, nurturing, support, I mean, drive, this is the engine. So if your core team, they are too busy with other, which is khair, right? They are very active, they are very respectful, and they are smart. So it fails, it drops immediately. So what do we do here is we tell the core team, Akhi, you are a subject matter expert, become an occasional, and let's build the core team with people who have time to actually to run it. So a lot of these examples, inshallah, they are there, and we documented a lot of them, and we can share that with you guys. I had something, but I forgot. She's saying, go ahead if you have another question. So what I was going to say is, there's a lifetime here, and I recommend 6 months to a year, and then you switch. Like the hub and spoke relationship has also to think trajectory. If there is a club is struggling and we know there are signs of decaying, the hub should interact through the spoke and say, okay, what's the issue here? Okay, 2 months from now, this will go down. Then we need to think ahead and say, probably you want to move to another club and so forth. Fadal.
You mentioned that some of these COPs started as friends and ended up at any.
Right.
How do we teach ourselves
That's a tough one, right? Ya akhi, subhanAllah, especially, and I'm sorry to say this, and I'm not trying to demean anyone, but in a Muslim community, we tend to be hard on ourselves. Once we disagree, it's like the sky is falling. I've been in projects, and I've been to so many cultures. I lived in China, I lived in Thailand, I lived in India, and I love India. And I see different cultures deal with this in a different way, but for some reason, Muslims tend to be like very harsh. We do have tools, and that's part of the intellectual dimension and the tarbiyah dimension in the beginning. When we talk about Islamic, the epistemology and the science of knowledge for Islamic framework, we give them tools about diffusing the anger, agreeing on a framework of disagreement, managing some of the disagreements using what I call agile mindset. And I don't want to pile on a lot of technical terms here. Agile mindset, it's like a funnel. It's like a funnel that takes all these passion and disagreement and delay it to the future. And then at the end, you're going to come out with some sort of a compromise. So the time is part of solving the disagreement and not ending up as an enemy or people who are just butting head all the time. It's called, it's part of the agile mindset and filtering the idea and the, I call it passionate opinion, not disagreement. Delay that passionate conflict to a later stage in your lifespan of the club, that by the time, inshallah, it will come down and we reach kind of this of agreement. We teach also what we call Again, I don't want to go technical, but if you read, so there is a classical philosophy, right? The philosophy and philosophers, and there is a new age of quantum philosophy. The quantum philosophy has to do with, you don't have to answer yes or no now. You don't have to have a binary, zero or one. You don't have a black or white. You don't. The quantum philosophy idea is, it's a superposition, it's unknown now. Let's leave it like that, and let's just carry on with a framework. Obviously, it's not just like random, right? There is a framework around the quantum philosophy, and then at some point, it will reveal itself. The right answer will reveal itself. We train them also on that quantum principles and so forth. I hope I'm not complicating things. Apologies. Did I take too long? I'm sorry. طيب جزاكم الله خيرا الحمد لله رب العالمين
جزاك الله خير for that insight. Brother Hisham, did you have something to share? Okay, inshallah. Yeah, so definitely time for a dhuhr break, inshallah. And there's lunch outside. We can catch a breather outside, inshallah. So we'll take a 1 hour break for we'll start at 2 o'clock, so a 45-minute break, inshallah. We'll be back in here at 2 o'clock. We'll hear from Brother Hisham a little bit about WVMA and its vision. Be careful, Brother Hisham. Dr. Hussein is here, so be careful with what you say. Anything you say will and can be used against you, inshallah. Now, I'm looking forward to that presentation. And then we'll talk about some of the clubs that they have in development, and then we'll hear from some of our imams and shuyukh, inshallah. So, dhuhr to prayer and lunch. Bismillah. For those of you tuning in live, we'll take a small break and we'll pick back up once we resume, inshallah.
طب انا مصلي مش فاهم ايه وجاي اسمع كده